So where does this story go? Well, it turns out that Musk Muscovy has other plans. They are also investing in space colonies. And the real source of resources of new materials for the Earth is going to be the asteroid belt. If we can get to first the close asteroids and then the farther asteroids, you can get all of the resources we need for Earth. If you find a very wet asteroid, you can put a bag around it and let the sun evaporate the water and collect all the water you need for people to live and work in outer space and to make rocket fuel. If you find another kind of asteroid, a metal-rich asteroid, you can use solar mirrors to melt it down, and a 1 kilometer metal asteroid, you could get the entire world's iron and steel production for the entire year, the entire world's gold and silver production for 10 to 100 years. And you can get 1,000 years production of platinum and other rare elements. All of this from one asteroid, 1 kilometer across, and there are millions of them. So this is one reason why many of us believe that our next target in space should be the asteroids. Now, mind you, I am very proud of the Apollo landings, and I think other people should go to the moon, but the moon is not as useful in the short term. Maybe one generation, two, three generations from now, but the moon is not the best goal right now. We should be getting out there to asteroids and getting all of those resources so that we no longer have to dig into our Mother Earth. We will be so rich, we can turn the Earth into a park, a garden. That sounds like a good compromise. Let's get very rich and make the Earth a garden and save all the species of the planet. I think that sounds like a good balance of things to do, and I think that we can get started on that job by 2050.